you for joining us for our gospel reflection from the Book of Common Prayer lectionary. My name is Father Tom Papazoglakis, and I serve as rector at St. George's Episcopal Church in Clifton Park, New York. Today is the 18th Tuesday after Pentecost. Let us pray. O God, you declare your almighty power chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Grant us the fullness of your grace, that we, running to obtain your promises, may become partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our lesson comes from the Gospel of Matthew, the 7th chapter, beginning at the first verse. Jesus said, "Do not judge so that you may not be judged. For with the judgment you make, you will be judged, and the measure you give will be the measure you get. Why do you see the speck in your neighbor's eye, but do not notice the log in your own eye? Or how can you say to your neighbor, 'Let me take this speck out of your eye,' while the log is in your own eye? You hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take the speck out of your neighbor's eye. Do not give what is holy to dogs, and do not throw your pearls before swine, or they will trample them underfoot and turn and maul you. Ask, and it will be given you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if your child asks for bread, will give you a stone? Or if the child asks for a fish, will give you a snake? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good things to those who ask him? In everything, do to others as you would have them do to you, for this is the law and the prophets." Here ends the lesson. The Pharisees were attempting to judge Jesus as if he were unfit to be a teacher, and certainly were not going to acknowledge him as their Messiah. In response, Jesus warned them against being hypocritical in their judgments. While being judgmental rarely, if ever, produces good, Jesus is not saying that judgment should never be made. We need to be very careful not to cast judgment on someone else, especially if we are not taking care to judge our own behaviors by an equal standard based on a proper understanding of God's righteousness. Jesus also says we should never entrust holy things or what is sacred to unholy people. He emphasized the nature of such an abuse, comparing the idiom of throwing pearls to pigs and judging others while ignoring our own failings or shortcomings. Jesus challenged those who were trying to judge him by turning their judgmental questioning back on them, saying, "How can you say to your neighbor, 'Let me take the speck out of your eye,' while the log is in your own eye?" He then calls them hypocrites when they do not first take the log out of their own eye before trying to take the speck out of their neighbor's eye. He follows this with another rebuke of the Pharisees, challenging them to refocus on the hopefulness found in a right relationship with God. Jesus reminds them who is in charge, assuring them that God welcomes all who turn to him with diligence and persistence. Listen to his words. "Ask, and it will be given you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened." The idea is that what people ordinarily want others to do for them should be what they practice toward others. This principle summarizes the essential teachings of the law and the prophets. But such a principle cannot be consistently practiced by people who are not righteous. Only a righteous person is able to practice this rule and thereby demonstrate the spiritual maturity and change that has come about within his or her life. An individual who is able to live this kind of life reflects the righteousness Jesus commanded. Let us pray. Almighty Father, whose blessed Son before his passion prayed for his disciples that they might be one, as you and he are one, grant that your church, being bound together in love and obedience to you, may be united in one body by the one Spirit, that the world may believe in him whom you have sent, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Join us every weekday for our gospel reflection. If you live in the Clifton Park area, join us for worship at 4:30 on Saturday afternoons or Sunday mornings at 8 or 9:30 a.m. If you're unable to join us in person, join us virtually through our YouTube channel. Our webpage provides recordings and details about all of our offerings.